Falcão?
Coming to the Zaza.
Oh, wow. Oh, the sculptural just beauty of some of these furniture selections. Oh, I'm so excited already. I can't even. Look at this sofa. Oh, wow. Oh my gosh, they're gonna make me drool this entire episode, aren't they? I like to always have a water bottle about the size of my head on hand. Hey friends, welcome back. I'm Lindsay, an interior stylist and teacher, here to help you create a home you truly love. In today's video, we're gonna take a little walk through another celebrity home to gather some much needed fresh inspiration for our homes in 2022. And do I have the best possible one for you today? It just came out. They are the cover of this month's AD magazine. That's right, Alicia Keys and Swizz Beatz. I am so excited to tour this home. It is so fresh, so fun. I haven't really seen all of it yet, obviously. I'm gonna watch it for the first time with you, as is customary here. And if you have any AD home tours, or honestly, any home tours that you'd like for me to take a look at and react to here with you, drop that link down below so I can check it out. Maybe it'll be the next home review video. First, let's take a look at these two incredible musicians, Alicia Keys and Swizz. There they are. Beatz. Ooh, controversial marriage with Swizz Beatz. Interesting. I really don't know that much about their personal lives. Ooh, the truth about Alicia Keys' relationship with Swizz Beatz. But as you can see, they are the most freaking beautiful couple ever. Oh my gosh, look at these two. Obviously, they both have fabulous fashion sensibilities, so it'll be really fun to see how they design their space. I don't probably have to explain to you who Alicia Keys is. You better know who she is. And if you don't, you better get on Spotify and find her right away. She is one of the best musicians ever. Here they are. Look at their beautiful wedding, it looks like. I wonder where they got married. We should look that up later. Is this the current home? Is this the home that we're gonna be looking at? Ooh, there is the cover of this month's Architectural Digest with these two on the cover, obviously in the home that we're about to see. I'm already beyond inspired. Look at this beautiful, stunning piece of art. Look at this amazing architectural wonder, this beautiful chair. They've got geometric shapes that make this chair happen. Oh, that's really cool. I'm also really loving the variety of plants we've got right out here. I'm wondering if that's like an outside patio. And then look at this rug, you guys. I am hot on the trail of the perfect rug for our primary bedroom here in the house, and I'm having a very hard time finding some ideas. I'm hoping this video is gonna give us some great ideas. Hair on my face. Alicia Keys and Swizz Beatz open the doors to their art-filled California mansion. Here they are. Look at this amazing outdoor space, and this chair is a knockout. You can tell they really are looking, oh my gosh, and look at the exterior of this home. Oh wow, this is quite the experience. An exterior view of Alicia Keys and Swizz Beatz home, which previously known as the Razor House, but has been dubbed Dreamland by the couple. Gosh, these windows and that infinity pool. Oh wow, that infinity pool. I am not a lover of swimming, but that pool would definitely make it happen for me. Inside Alicia Keys and Swizz Beatz Oceanside Mansion, open door Architectural Digest home tour. I'm all in, you guys. Look at these little preview images. There is gonna be so much incredible art in here, I can tell.
What's up, what's up, what's up?
AD, how are you? I'm Mrs. Dean.
Mr. Cute. Dean right here.
And we wanna invite you into our home. Come.
Coming to the Zaza.
Oh, wow. Oh, the sculptural just beauty of some of these furniture selections. Oh, I'm so excited already. I can't even. Look at this sofa. Oh, wow. Oh my gosh, they're gonna make me drool this entire episode, aren't they? I am dreaming about all the finished furniture right now.
You know, the house is very open, so we occupy all the spaces in the home, but there is something about the circle that feels so good, especially with the view and the water, which feels so calming and peaceful. This is the perfect way to welcome people in. It's comfortable.
We wanted something that felt warm, something that feels like places we traveled around the world, and you know, with this view and with with these colors, it just locks us into the universe.
My love loves clean lines. He's really about just the everything feeling really clean. It's almost like it doesn't obstruct you as you're imagining, dreaming, thinking.
This sofa. So I'm kind of obsessed right now with all the different furniture that I'm dreaming about owning someday for our home. And one of the key pieces I'm looking for is a very sculptural, round, sort of interesting, artistic sofa. I don't want that sort of everyday sofa that every person has, that chaise lounge, you know, three-seater that's at literally every website. This is such a great example of how you can have something that is sculptural and interesting and beautiful and calming and welcoming, and it doesn't have to look like every other cookie cutter sofa out there. I don't doubt that this was a very expensive piece of furniture. I would like to look that up, actually. You could find a lot of different things that sort of hit this feel without spending what I assume is in the tens of thousands of dollars here. And it's definitely screaming that sort of 70s Italian designer feeling that's so hot right now. Oh yeah, this is, I'm loving it.
Then we do a lot here. We do a lot of dreaming. Virgo. He's definitely a Virgo. But we do a lot of dreaming.
Yes.
Look through into the dining and what I'm assuming is the kitchen, sort of entry, living, kind of hangout, sitting area space that we're in right now is so light and bright, but all neutral. And then it looks into this dining kitchen land that's a more deeper brown tone, still in that warm color palette. Oh, it is stunning. Mark my words, these chairs are on my list for some of the hottest trending pieces for 2022 video to come.
Everything was curated. Everything was designed for the space.
Curated. That is the most important word here.
Kids love Iron Man. They're like, that's the Iron Man house. Listen, not only kids.
Grown-ups.
Grown-ups like this too. Oh, look at that photograph. That kitchen. I keep thinking about black countertops, you guys.
So this is one of the favorite places in the house. The house is an open layout, so you can really just experience it as an open space, but we love hanging out here. We love eating here.
Those chairs are stunning. So they've got this shearling upholstery in this sort of warm brown tone that's become pretty popular lately for good reason. It looks so cozy and comfy. I'm definitely looking forward to adding something with that fabric sometime in our house. And then I like this sort of lighter toned wood, a natural rug. And you can see there's not a lot of color, there's not a lot of pattern. It's just an overall soothing aesthetic with some interest paid in the art pieces. You've got these sort of stacked stone pieces on the far right, beautiful live plants, metal, organic, a lot of really cool art pieces.
We play cards, we play dice, we play board games, and then a lot of times we'll just casually eat at the counter in the kitchen. It's really kind of whatever's happening. If the lunch is going on, we'll just gather around the counter and chill out. We love to cook. We love to just have our friends and family over.
I am loving the wall art in this space. One thing that I'm really liking about this overall design aesthetic, and something that I'm trying to do in our home too, is relying on a palette of mostly warm neutral tones. That way you can layer in really beautiful, bright colors in your artwork, and that draws the attention of the eye to the artwork rather than something like an area rug or a light fixture.
Always music playing.
Always music playing.
That does not surprise me about this couple.
If music's playing, he's up. We love this set. It is so special. It feels somehow simple yet very luxurious at the same time, and it has a great amount of seats for entertaining and friends and family. This is a family home. We have our kids here. Our kids have their friends over, everything like that. So we definitely, you know, feel like we can also still eat on these, which is important. You know,
the dog definitely feels that he can drool.
Dog friendly, very important.
Wiping up.
To the family room we go.
They're so cute together. I really love them together. Aren't they sweet? Okay, that sectional is like Kamalianda adjacent.
So we're in the formal dining room. This is also the family room. That's what I love. It's a beautiful structure, but it's also quite casual too. You know, we mix the spaces together. You know, the formal dining room is in the family room. We're watching TV in this room.
So I definitely agree with her. She's got definitely a little bit of a more upscale, dressy, formal side to this design. And then they also have a lot of casual pieces to balance things out and make it feel like you can just kind of lounge and hang out. I'm definitely loving these beautiful, what I would assume to be Moroccan area rugs. I've seen a couple so far in this home, and that really kind of softens this travertine tile. I love this channel tufted sectional. It's massive, but it obviously fits the space pretty well. They've got a big television, so they're a busy family. You can see this is a real living space, not just something where they're trying to make it look showy for when people come over. And they're putting all of that focal point emphasis into these colorful art pieces. I am loving this long, almost sort of surfboard-esque dining table and the beautiful sculptural chairs. They really have an eye for sculptural, artistic furniture pieces, really just doing a lot of the things that I'm goaling myself to do in our home. Carefully searching out, curating, and bringing things into our space that could really mix and match and live anywhere, but still fit into the overall aesthetic of our home. A lot of emphasis on natural stone, natural wood tones. We're not pulling focus to a big bold print in an area rug here. All of the attention is driving you right to these beautiful art pieces.
We're playing loud movies, we're falling asleep on the couch, we're having, you know, holiday dinners, whatever the case is.
This is the glass. This is a beautiful space. And look how you can see into this outdoor living space.
We can open the doors and dine outside as well. We can play, we can jump in the pool. It's a very open type of way.
I mean, this home is like a resort outside. Look at this.
Amazing. Derek Adams here, which is occupying the entire wall. And it's so beautiful because we get to see kind of the fun of swimming and having a good time. We know we're right on the water, so it fits into.
It feels like it's like a family portrait of our family.
Oh, that is such a sweet story. I love that. It's a beautiful piece for their home, and it clearly leads out into this back patio resort outdoor swimming space, and so it's perfect for their family.
Never really seen black people swimming in pools too much, so that piece was like real strong for the living room.
Yes, I love art that speaks to you personally. That's what you should fill your home with.
So this is a really special room for us. I think it has a wide spectrum of art and life and experience in it, and it feels really good. We love that our kids are able to grow up seeing such dynamic art around them.
It's like a gift you give to your children, filling their world with art and literature and music.
We do own the largest collection of Gordon Parks, and so we're very
Gordon Parks.
This one right here, this one spoke to the living room. It's like to mix the photography, you know, and with the furniture, it just felt like the perfect mix.
I just love that little vignette, if you will, in the corner here. We've got this beautiful Gordon Parks, and then these interesting, I would assume to be African masks. Oh, wow. It's just such an interesting mix of all these beautiful things. And then you've got a lot of hard edges here, so they've softened it with some beautiful pink flowers. It just goes to show that you can really create balance in so many different ways between texture, between elements, between materials, and between hard and soft. I'm also loving, they're not talking about them, but these natural woven baskets just behind their legs here just adds another bit, a little bit more woven texture, which we love in a space. Oh, let's just all go buy baskets this weekend. Let's do it.
And I love this knit cave. I actually think my favorite thing about
knit cave,
it's so shockingly detailed. And all of these amazing
shout
buttons.
Shout out to Joanna from Jack Shaman for hooking
this
up.
I mean, that is
incredible.
Intense.
Incredible.
I love.
I have the respect for Knit Cave. I do. Let's roll back on this. I just don't know if I would put it in my home.
Favorite thing about the Knit Cave pieces, just how it's so shockingly detailed.
I mean, but gosh, you know, when you have the money supporting artists that you love and believe in and that, you know, kind of change your thinking, I'm always a big believer in that.
And then Miss Jordan Castile is so special.
I just love how she's sitting in this room with us.
I couldn't wait to hear about this Jordan Castile piece. It is absolutely stunningly beautiful. I love massive, huge art pieces. Even when you have a small space, don't be afraid to buy large pieces, especially art pieces. You really need something to make a small space feel larger, and you can achieve that through a variety of methods. The first and easiest method to me is hanging curtains as high as you can. That's going to really elevate the height of the ceiling and make even a small space feel larger. But the next one is, you know, a lot of people would do this in a small space where you'll just buy a ton of small art pieces, and it's just gonna look cluttered. I'm just gonna say it. I used to do that when I lived in a studio apartment. I used to collect a lot of small art pieces, and then that ended up becoming a lot of gallery walls all over my apartment, which inherently make a space feel a little smaller, in my opinion, just a bit cluttered. And so when you remove that and you just focus on one really large statement piece of art, you can hang it, I mean, even just a couple inches from the ceiling all the way down to almost your baseboards. You could fill a whole wall space that just isn't big enough for a piece of furniture with a huge painting like this, and it creates such a moment in the space. That way you can layer in a couple of stools, a couple of plants, and now a kind of pass through space that didn't feel like anything now has this sort of focal energy.
I just love how she's sitting in this room with us. Like,
yes.
It's like life-size portraiture.
Thought-provoking, and I think we love to do that with the art.
Yes.
I mean, the shelf styling. I love all the layering. We've got some historical antique books. We've got a lot more African masks from different places, a lot of different handmade pots, antiques. I just love the overall just mix of everything. I even think I see some fertility goddesses over there. I'm just very interested in the whole styling. And this is very interesting wall shelving. I haven't seen any quite like this. I like that where part of it's closed and part of it's open. So you have closed storage for the things that you don't want to see. Technology, kids' toys, what have you. And then you also have some styling opportunities, which we always love. Oh my gosh, that bent wood. I can't even imagine how much that floating credenza with bent wood fronts. I don't even want to know the cost. I just know if I won the lottery, I would be trying to source this piece of furniture. It's stunning. It's absolutely stunning.
So we love it up here. The bedrooms are up here. The kids' rooms are up here. It's action-packed over here.
Action-packed. Radcliffe Bailey.
I love Radcliffe Bailey. Just something about this that's so, especially with the music notes behind it.
I love Radcliffe Bailey.
I love how there's like the work inside the work.
This is a masterclass on collecting art. Now, a lot of this art is way out of our price range. Let's just be honest. I'm a teacher by day. You know, I'm not out there searching for $16,000 pieces of art, $100,000 pieces of art like these two celebrities. However, we can take this inspiration to comb our own local world, look for art shows, look for antique fairs, flea markets. Original art doesn't have to be new, number one. So finding vintage art pieces can be a really great way to source things that are unique and interesting. You can also, again, look for local artists, look for local art shows. Become a patron of somebody that you admire. I find artists on Instagram all the time. I'm gonna link a few of my favorite artists that I love to stalk their work and dream about owning down below. And I'm hoping that you might feel inspired to just maybe pass up the mass-produced art aisle at Target, Home Goods, wherever it is that you're shopping, and really think about how can I look for artists to support and interesting, unique, one-of-a-kind pieces to build my interior design around.
Gosh, so special. Love this one. Yeah, I guess we call this the library. We call it the piano room. Egypt practices piano here. I practice piano here. We definitely, you know, kind of relax, lounge, read, chill.
All the beautiful stoneware.
Just kind of hanging out here thinking.
But it's about keeping the warm and warm colors because, you know.
That's another thing that's trending right now. A couple of things that I'll definitely be sharing in my upcoming Trends for 2022 video. We got this very light wood with chunky, thick legs, again, on these chairs. These are a little bit more blocky than the last ones. We're a bit more cylindrical, but still same idea. We also have this lamp on three little feet. So you've noticed throughout their home, there's a lot of little pedestal bowls on feet. This little lamp is on feet. There was a pedestal bowl in their kitchen that had little feet on it. So lots of really pretty things there. And then the last one is organic shaped coffee tables. Take a look at what we have here. So instead of having a really curvy sofa in this room, like they had in that circular sitting room at the beginning of the video, now we've got these sort of bean shaped marble coffee tables at different heights too. That's another thing that's definitely been super popular lately in both angular coffee tables and these more organic shapes. And I'm loving this little pop of color with the beautiful, beautiful portraiture in the back wall here. This art collection is beyond impressive. I love it. So you can really see the blueprint of what they've done here. Light tone upholstery on the sofa, wood framed furniture being center stage here. We've got that on the sectional, the armchairs, and the coffee table. Neutral textural rug here. It looks to be some sort of jute or other natural fiber. And then we've got the color infusion is really in a couple of art pieces, floral arrangements, very natural fabric pillows that look to be obviously handmade. And then we've got some color in books and other accessories. This is so easy, especially when you don't want to spend a fortune like redoing your home every time you get bored. If you change out the art, change out a pillow, you have kind of a new feeling in a space like this without redoing everything, buying all new sofa, furniture, yada, yada, you get the drift.
You know, this house is, you know, the Iron Man house. So that means that it's, you know, it's kind of industrial in a way. It can be kind of cold.
It's very industrial.
I wanted to just warm it up and bring the energies with the rugs and the different tones that we purposely picked.
They've definitely brought in the cozy factor here through the chenille on the sofa.
Read them both together.
So that's a textural rug. It's a nod to a lot of different ancient cultures. That was a point. One time
they have a beautiful sculptural collection as well here.
You know, the feeling of Bali and the way that it feels so comfortable and open and beautiful, and also...
Yeah, but it's a mixture of everything.
It
now.
Is.
I mean, because even like these ceramics over here is
Julia
Chang.
They're beautiful. Yeah. If I'm playing, sometimes people will hang out. If I'm practicing with Egypt, you know, his brother will be here chilling.
I get free concerts.
I mean, yeah, he won the lottery, you guys. Free Alicia Keys concerts anytime he wants. Brilliant.
This piano is a very important piano, actually. This piano is my very first piano ever. So my son gets to play on my first piano when I first was signed to Columbia Records.
Not too shabby getting piano lessons from Mama Alicia Keys. That would be pretty awesome. Way to go. Take advantage of that, children. Now we get a free concert. I love how they both dress to match the home. I find a lot of celebrities do that for these videos. Very smart, because you're essentially walking around your home and showing it off. You want to look good in it. They're cute. I want to know what's controversial about their marriage. I did not heard about this. I'm going to have to do some reading after this video. If you know the scoop, let me know in the comments.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Wow. Thanks for coming through, AD. We love having you. But you got to go home.
I mean, come on, this home was insane. It was gorgeous. I don't know what my favorite part was. I knew we were in for some artistic treats in this home. I had no idea how much covetable furniture we would come across. If you love sourcing inspiration for your home through home tours like this, make sure to hit that subscribe button and the little notification bell. I put out new videos every single Wednesday, and let me know which house tour you'd like to see featured next. Pop on over here and take a look through Nate Berkus and Jeremiah Brent's New York City townhome. I reviewed that one last time and it's absolutely stunning. All right, you guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a great rest of your week, and I will see you in the next one. Bye, my friends. That's so sweet.